Welcome to the lecture of MATLAB basic commands. In this lecture you will learn about some desktop basics, how to write matrices and arrays, how to access elements of any matrix by using their indices, how to use workspace, how to write strings in MATLAB codes, how to use MATLAB functions, two-dimensional and three-dimensional plots, how to write scripts. At the end we will discuss how to use help command in MATLAB. Before starting our lecture, please subscribe our channel and click on bell icon to get notifications about our new lectures. Starting from MATLAB interface, only four sections are shown here. These are the current folder, command window, workspace and command history. We will start this lecture by assigning a simple integer to some variable. There is no need to initialize any variable in MATLAB. A variable can be assigned a value by simply writing a equals to 10. Or b equals to 20. Simple arithmetic operations can also be done simply by doing a plus b. Arrays and matrices are always written in square brackets. The columns of a vector can be differentiated with spaces or commas in between them. Consecutive rows in a column vector can be differentiated with a semicolon in between the elements. A matrix can be created by writing the elements row-wise, that is, the first row will be written and then a semicolon will be used to move on to the next row. Basic arithmetic operations on matrices are also simple to perform, like D plus E, D minus E. There are two types of multiplications and divisions in matrices, that is a simple matrix division and multiplication and point to point or element wise multiplication and division, D multiplied by E. Point to point division can be performed by putting a dot before multiplication or division sign. In this division, the first element of D is divided by the first element of E, the second element of D is divided by the second element of E, and so on. Concatenation of two matrices can be done in the same way as writing a new matrix. If the second matrix has to be added under the first matrix, both of them will be separated by a semicolon. If the second matrix has to be on the right side of the first matrix, both matrices will be separated with a space or comma in between them. Every variable in MATLAB is an array that can hold many numbers. These numbers can be accessed using indexing. There are two ways to refer to a particular element in an array. The most common way is to specify row and column subscript, such as fourth row and second column. Sometimes it is also useful to use a single subscript, such as the eighth element of this array. Using an assignment statement, you can specify the element using indexing as well, even outside of its current dimension. Colon operator is used to refer to the multiple elements of an array. For example, list the elements in the first three rows and second column of A. The colon alone, without start or end values, specifies all of the elements in that dimension. For example, all the elements in the third row of A. The colon operator also allows you to create an equally spaced vector of values. From start, then comes the interval and end. All the variables which are used here can be seen in the workspace with their values. The properties of all the variables which are to be shown in the workspace can be selected from here. A variable can be assigned a string value by simply writing the string in inverted commas. Similar to numeric arrays, string arrays can have multiple elements as well. Calling a MATLAB function is also very simple. Inputs are passed to the function in round brackets. Two-dimensional plot of sine wave can be plotted using plot command, where the first input is an array which consists of the values of y-axis, and second input consists of the values of x-axis. The axis can also be labeled by using the commands xlabel and ylabel. A title can also be given to the plot by using the title command. By adding a third input argument to the plot function, the line specification of the plot can also be changed. Multiple plots can also be plotted in a single figure by holding the first plot and then plotting the second one. A legend to the plot can also be added with the first one for the first plot and the second one for the second plot and so on. 3D plotting is also very simple in MATLAB. All we need is a set of three variables which are going to be plotted in three dimensions. For this, mesh grid command is used to create a two-dimensional grid coordinates based on coordinates contained in input vectors. The third variable is generated as an exponential function of x and y. Then the surf command is used to plot in three dimensions. Multiple plots or figures can also be shown in a single figure but in separate windows using subplot command. We are going to create two rows and two columns of sub-windows in a single figure. And the third input argument of subplot command represents on which plot we are working right now. The z-axis itself was an exponential function. In the fourth subplot, the exponential function is plotted with respect to x and y. Scripts in MATLAB, which are also sometimes referred as the M files, can be generated in editor. The script file can be saved at any location with any name, in the current folder or in any other folder. In this script, a sphere is going to be generated using the sphere command, which generates x, y, and z coordinates of a sphere. Defining the radius as 2, plot this sphere in 3 dimensions using the surf command. Running the script file by clicking on the run button at the top of this editor file. Within any scripts, some sections of code can be executed repeatedly in a loop or under some conditions. For or while command is used for loops and conditional statements use if or switch commands. For example, in this script, the first 100 numbers of Fibonacci sequence are going to be generated. In this sequence, the first two numbers are 1 and each subsequent number is the sum of previous two numbers. As an example for conditional statements, a number is generated between 1 and 100 randomly and then the size is given to that number based on the conditions. If the number is less than 34, the size given to that number is low. If the number is less than 67 and greater than 34, the size given to that number is medium. And if the number is greater than 67, the size given to that number is high. All the MATLAB functions have supporting documentation that includes examples and describes the function inputs, outputs, and calling syntax. There are several ways to access the information in MATLAB. One way to access the information about any function in MATLAB is to write the function in help bar at the top right corner of MATLAB interface. A new help window will be opened with all the information about that command. For example, the command whose lists in alphabetical order the names, sizes, and types of all the variables in currently active workspace. Some examples are also given with their purpose. Another way to open the help window in MATLAB is to use the doc command. Strlength returns the number of characters in each element of the input string array. It also defines what are the inputs and what are the outputs. Some examples are also given with their brief description as well. The third way to access information about any command is to use the help command. It defines the purpose of mesh grid command, that is, it replicates the grid vectors xgv and ygv to produce the coordinates of a rectangular grid x and y. in 2 dimensions. This command can also be used in 3 dimensions with the third input and third output. In the information section, all the possible uses of that specific command are listed with their specific examples as well. The best way to use the help in MATLAB is either to write in the help bar or use the doc command. This is all for this lecture. Please do not forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.